Hey guys, this is StuMurray47 here, back with another action figure review. And in today's review, guys, I'm going to be continuing in my Superman Last Son line of reviews, which essentially covers the... basically, it was November 2007, DC Collectibles released a four-figure wave, which essentially chronicled the Superman Last Son comic series, which was available through Action Comics. Now, I've already done the Superman review for this line, guys, so if you happen to stumble upon this video first, feel free to click on the link below and you'll get the Superman figure, which will not only give you details about the figure, but it gives you the entire storyline as well. So if you guys are interested in the story or wonder, you know, where this guy came from, it'll kind of chronicle that for you. So it is a long video, unfortunately, but I did cover quite a lot in there. So anyway, onto this figure. Now, of course, this was, I think, the second figure in the wave that was released, which, of course, is General Zod. Now, any of you General Zod fans out there might notice he looks slightly different from any incarnation that you may be used to. But essentially, this is exactly how he looks in the book itself. Now, the actual costume he's wearing, apparently, are Kryptonian prison robes or Kryptonian prison uniforms. Both he and Ursa are wearing them in the storyline, as is Non, which, unfortunately, I'm really upset, but he wasn't turned into a figure for this line. I would have really loved to have had a Non figure. But this, you know, it really does reflect this figure. You know, I mean, they look identical. The art by Adam Kubert. I like the look, to be honest. I mean, it's a really sort of unique look for Zod. I like the sort of the glasses he's wearing all the way throughout, and this big long flowing jacket as well looks really nice. So I'm just going to start off by giving you guys a quick 360 of the figure. So I'll just move him a little bit closer, and I'll just give you guys a quick 360. So as you can see, there's some really, really nice sculpting in this figure, guys. Especially, you know, when you go into the coat here, I love that he's got a hood as well, which obviously isn't over his neck there. And some gorgeous, gorgeous detail. Now, I'm guessing this is the symbol for Zod. Obviously, it may be mentioned in the book. It's been a while since I read any specifics or that piece, but I'm guessing that's probably the symbol for Zod. Obviously, it wasn't in the original movie, certainly, but I mean, because Richard Donner was one of the co-writers of this, I think it's really quite telling that he used Zod in there. But obviously, this figure's going to split opinions, I think, if only because he has one of the, unfortunately, the dreaded pre-posed kind of style. What I mean by that is, of course, that there are only a few positions that you can really stand him in. I know that's pretty par for the course for DC Direct, because they have such limited articulation. You're not going to be doing really dynamic poses. These are essentially, I like to refer to them as staction figures, you know, part statue, part action figure. But what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to give you guys a bit of closer detail. Now, as with the Superman figure, you are going to notice that he has the standard Superman base there, which of course has got the really vibrant red and yellow, which I think looks great. It's quite funny seeing General Zod standing on a Superman base. It kind of goes against the entire character of Zod, but I'll just give you guys a bit of a close-up here of the details, and they've done a really, really great job with the sculpt here. Obviously, General Zod, I think some of the key features, of course, he has to have the beard, you know, he has to have that kind of goatee and the hair. Of course, Terrence Stamp, who played him, barely had any hair, you know, he was trying to hold on to as much as he had, but... this is great. I even love the kind of the spikes at the back of the hair here. It's almost like he's going fast on a motorbike or something. His hair looks like it's swept back. But gorgeous. I love the way that the glasses themselves are obviously added later. You can actually see the eyes sculpted behind them. So I'm guessing with enough force you could probably get these things off. Not that I'd ever do that, but really great. And as I said, the cloak itself... The sculpting work on it is really, really top-notch, the way it kind of drapes down here and comes all the way back. Now, it is quite a tough plastic. You can move it, certainly, but it's not got much give to it. Just really great. Of course, of the details, you can see there that the symbol here, which kind of looks like an eye symbol. Obviously, I'm guessing it's the symbol for Zod. He's actually got the neck tattoo as well, so that's a really good detail. And... obviously, the sculpting work going down here showing that the trousers or the pants are just a bit too long for him and all bunched up at the bottom. just brilliant. I mean, they didn't really have to do this. I'm sure that obviously if they'd made the figure, these crease marks that you see in the chest here didn't have to be there, but they just really add some dimension and some nice shadows to the figure. Okay, so on to articulation. Similar to Superman in this wave, there is limited head articulation in that it only goes left and right. It will do a full 360, but would of course kill him if I did that, so that won't be happening. He does have a ball joint in his arms. It's very limited though. Or it might actually not. I mean, I'm not going to force it, but I mean, it really only gives this kind of movement here, so it's quite minor. It does go forward and back. Now, it does go really... It'll do a full 360. I thought it was going to be hampered by this, but because this piece is quite rubbery, it does allow for good movement. He has a bend at the elbow, and he does have a spin at the wrist and inside the cuff here, or inside the... the cuff. Now, his legs... as I said, where mixed opinions are going to be. Now, he does have forward and back, he does have a bend at the knees, and he has no ankle articulation. However, this leg, even with the leg straight, or the knee straight, you can see it's actually at a bend. So he's always going to have a bend in that leg. It's almost like he's taking a step forward. He does stand very well, though, but you can see here, it's like he's standing. But, of course, I like the pointing finger as well, so that you can... You know, you can have some good kind of pointing poses, or you can see here his elbow's a little loose. You know, just a little touch, they not go down, but the way I've got him posed, that's not going to be an issue. So, yeah, I can't recommend him highly enough, guys. I love this hood detail. Obviously, it's attached to the back here, so it's not moving, and of course, you can see how shiny his hair is with the light there. But a brilliant figure, obviously, for a... Superman completists. I mean, not only do I collect Superman, but I collect all his villains as well. So be it Zod, Bizarro, Cyborg, Superman, Darkseid, etc. You know, or Doomsday. I collect all his main villains. So, of course, I had to get this figure. Now, I don't have many General Zod figures, to be honest. Obviously, this is probably the only official one that I have. I think it's the only official one that's been released, not including really old-fashioned Mego figures, things like that. I do have one other General Zod figure, which I'm sure you guys have probably seen the review of. This was actually a custom, but of course this is a custom General Zod using his kind of movie costume there. You can see, of course, he's got the kind of the black leather boots and the leather trim. But I like this. It's a custom from a Ra's al Ghul or Ra's al Ghul figure from DC Direct, and I just think it looks really, really great. And of course the two of them go quite well together, certainly. But this one on the left is the only official one, I think, that we've really been given from DC Direct. Now, I do have another General Zod figure, which is a DC Unlimited, you know, one of the small 3¾ ones. But I'm going to show that in a later review. I don't want to reveal that one just yet. So anyway, thanks guys, thanks for watching. The next review is probably going to be Ursa. I think she was the third release in this line. Before I go though, I know you'll be fed up me mentioning this, but my friend Chapman Films actually has a competition or a giveaway going at the moment. So if you want to click in the link on the bottom there, I've put a link to one of his videos. He's actually giving away three different prizes, and all he wants to get is 250 subscribers. Now he's almost there, and of course anyone watching this, if you're interested in getting a free figure, all you need to do is sub his channel, so just click subscribe if you go to the link and subscribe to him. If you just go into the comment box and comment what you would like him to give you, he's got three things he's giving away. There's the Justice League Unlimited Stripe figure. He has a Hal Jordan and Kyle Rayner 2-pack, that's 6-inch DC Universe, and he also has the thing I'm interested in, which is the DC Unlimited Superman Metallic New 52 figure. So there's no catch. If you just subscribe to him, obviously leave a comment there, you've got just as much chance as anyone else, so hopefully we'll get him to 250 subscribers, and hopefully I'll win. But as I said, guys, it's a good friend of mine. He's got really funny videos, so if you do subscribe to him, I've no doubt that you'll stay subscribed to him and enjoy his reviews. But I'll go just now. As I said, thanks for watching. I really appreciate you watching, all my subscribers. I really enjoy what I'm doing, and I hope you guys are having fun too. So see you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye. Hey guys, a quick tack on the end here. I totally forgot to compare the figures to the comic art they're based on. So here's a few shots from the comic, and you can see that General Zod looks really accurate to the way he looked in the comics here. I love, you know, the same flowing robe and the sort of creases in the costume. So sorry I forgot this in the main review, guys, but I thought I'd tack it on the end just to give you guys a bit of a comparison. Bye.